A courtroom packed to its capacity listened in stunned silence as the affidavit of accused number one, 27-year-old Vusi Mabaso, was read out.
On that fateful day, the first person to be struck was Dudu, and it was on a Thursday. She came to the house, and after some time, I struck her with the said hammer, and she died, and I placed her at the back of the outside room. Mbali was the second person. She came home from work with Sibonga, the young girl. I then struck her with the hammer and suffocated the young child that was with her.
Mabaso says he intends to plead not guilty to the crimes. He insists he was forced to kill and feared for his life. Mabaso claims accused number two, Fida Kupe, and a gang of men from Cape Town kidnapped him 3 years ago. He says they forced him into a life of crime and instructed him to move to Johannesburg to kill the Khoza family. Mabaso alleges Kupe was in the house when some of the murders took place and issued instructions for the killings.
I then raped Kababa in his presence, and after that, he watched me suffocate the same children in his presence. Paragraph T. The bodies were placed behind the bedrooms. He realized that there was a bad smell and gave me money to buy detergents.
But in his affidavit, Cooper claims his co-accused is lying. Police say both men can be placed at the scene of the crime.
Kodwa iphutha kalenzile uthe makafika abantu abane bebengakashoni labantu abane laba abashonise kakhona ngensuku ezimbili ehlukene bengeke kwenzeke ukuthi abantu abane bagqitshwe ngalendlela abagqitshwe ngayendlini angaboni nekusakhona.
The man's bid for bail continues on Thursday. Lindokuhle Xulu, Protea.